God said, if you commit sin against God that could be considered a betrayal of trust with God, then you shall feel guilt. I believe that this is where the term Jewish guilt comes from. You shall acknowledge the sin and do the repair to make it better. The third time God spoke to Moses, God said, tell Aaron to bless the sons of Israel by saying, may God bless you and keep you. May God illuminate the Almighty countenance for you and favor you. May God lift up God's countenance towards you and establish peace for you. They shall place my name upon the sons of Israel, and as for me, I shall bless them. And not so, men and women had the option to take the vow of a Nazir. That meant that they could make themselves a temporary priest. If they did this, there were many obligations. Some of these were not shaving their head, not drinking wine or anything that come from the grapevine, and not coming in contact with the dead. Eventually, Moses finished setting up the dwelling place, and the heads of the tribes brought offerings that included money, animals, flour, gold, incense, and silver. All 12 tribes brought the exact same thing, but all were appreciated equally. The first of the two themes that I found within my Torah portion is repetition that never gets old and is appreciated every time. Each tribal leader offered God the exact same thing, and God took each offering as special. This can relate to my life in the real world in many ways. One way I try to practice this in my own life is by simply saying thank you. Whenever I'm in a car with an adult and they drive me somewhere, I try my hardest to remember to say thank you. Thank yous are an example of something that if you say it no matter how many times, it never gets old and is appreciated every time. To look at this another way, I believe that no matter what you bring to an experience, whether it is the same or different as someone else, if you bring something, that is enough. Bringing a gift is always a nice gesture, but bringing the gift of laughter, listening, understanding, acceptance, and respect is more important. I pride myself on being a good listener and hope that people will look to me over and over if they need help in any way. The idea of intention, or kavanah, is important in Judaism. It is always my intention to be a good person. As God said in my Torah portion, if you do make a mistake, there is room for repair. While my intention is to always be a good person, there are times when I may be frustrated with my sister or parents and annoyed or short with a friend. I do my best to take responsibility and do the repair needed. I think if everyone acknowledged their mistakes, there would be a lot more peace in the world. The second of the two themes that I found in my Torah portion is doing your part within a society or community. I see this often at my middle school, EBIA. One of our six innovator norms is citizenship and leadership. I try to embrace this norm as much as possible inside and outside of school. Personally, I believe that we have to work together to get things accomplished. I have a tendency to be a leader, whether it is sports team or a school group project. Being a leader does not mean doing the whole project myself, but rather help everyone work collaboratively and find everyone's strengths. This also connects to my Bar Mitzvah project, which is donating baseball equipment to underprivileged youth around the world through a nonprofit organization, Pitch In for Baseball. I'm currently working with the San Francisco Giants to collect donations, and will be taking a road trip with my dad down to LA to deliver the equipment. My goal is to give others the gift of play. I see this as doing my part in the society by giving to all the kids who aren't as lucky as you and me. This is an example of tikkun olam, which means repairing the world. Repairing the world is important right now because the world is having some major problems, between climate change, discrimination and prejudice, and political differences. In this day and age, it is even more important for my generation to come together and do our part to protect and include each other and take care of the earth. You might ask how donating equipment is repairing the world, and I would say that reusing and recycling equipment while bringing people together to play is just that. Doing my part as a bar mitzvah to repair the world is my way of continuing what my ancestors believed in, show gratitude to those who have helped me through the years, and make the future a better place. Going back to my Torah portion, we all have a role to play, whether it is big or small, but it is important that we each give back however we can. I wouldn't be here today without my community. There are so many people that got me to this day. Thank you to all of my friends and family who traveled to be here. Thank you to all of my East Bay friends and family who have been with me through this process. Thank you to Jay Kramars for helping me write this speech. Isaac Zillins for leading this amazing service. Kiki Lipset for teaching me how to read and write Hebrew. Thank you to Elijah Gabule for going through this process with me and always putting a smile on my face. And my grandparents, who each play a unique and special role in my life. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for helping with everything and making this possible, and to my little sister, Sammy, for being patient through this fun and terrifying process. Thank you, and Shabbat Shalom.
Thank you. Alright, this is my big chance to give Adam a blessing. Sort of like the, I now pronounce you a bar mitzvah kind of moment. Well, first of all, did anybody donate baseball equipment? Is there anybody who's donated baseball equipment? One in the back. Nice job, Jack. Alright. Jack, next to Jack. Okay, very cool. I think that's a cool project. When I had a bar mitzvah, not to make it about me, I had Noah, it was my Torah portion, and I compared Noah to like a baseball manager and all the animals to the team. So I'm very connected to this. Josh told me that probably the supplies are going to go to Uganda. There's a good chance, possibly. Yeah. And I just wanted to point out this kippot that Adam and Josh are wearing are also from Uganda. They're handmade by a Jewish community in Uganda, a small Jewish community there. Uganda, yeah. I'm sort of overwhelmed where to start, Adam. I was just so impressed by you. This has really, really been a great process for me to get closer to you. I've known you for a while and liked you for a long time. There's a few things you said in your speech that I wanted to highlight. I'll get to that in a second. Well, first of all, so Adam, part of our connection is through Camp Tawanga. We've had a really good time. Adam's amazing, and he also has an amazing group of friends. It's like really special to be around some of them in the back there. Just take a little credit as well. And I'll give you kind of an example. We did our very first event, the very first time we've had this bar mitzvah program for Camp Tawanga. We didn't really know how it was going to go. We had all these parents coming, a lot of them, a little bit, is this going to be good or not good? And I'm trying to lead some music, and Adam jumps up right away and starts helping with the hand motions and clapping and pointing, just so helpful. And being one of the oldest people in the program, he kind of sets the tone for the other young people in the program as well. So this is just one example of, where Adam steps up to be a leader in a way that just makes everything go well. And that was a moment where I just in particular appreciated that. And I guess it just, I feel like I'm not going to be alone in just saying how easy it is for me to say I'm just excited for you to grow up and take more leadership and to be responsible for things. And I just have so much faith that you're going to know what's the right thing to do and to do it. And the only thing I just want to say is that I hope that all these good deeds that you do, that you don't do them out of Jewish guilt. It's true. Like if I gave you a ride and you said thank you, I would really appreciate that. And I also hope that you get to say it from your heart, not out of a place where you're worried that I may or may not like you, depending on if you say thank you. Someone once said to me, and I think this is a nice thing in terms of a wish, is that you, Adam, are good not because of what you do, but you do what you do because you're good. Which is a little complex to sort through, but I'll just say really quickly, you are already good. No matter what you do or what you don't do, you are already good through and through. And hopefully, because you're so good, that leads to you doing the things that you do. Not that you need to do those things in order for people to see you as good and to take you in. So I hope that you continue to do the good that you do and that you just know you're already good. There's nothing more you need to do and you get to enjoy yourself, especially tonight. I hope you just don't worry about the details of helping your parents and all. You just get to have a good time with your friends and enjoy. So I'm going to offer the priestly blessing. You mentioned it in our Torah. This week's Torah portion spells out the priestly blessing, which is what I've been building up to here. The priestly blessing, it's the oldest blessing that we have in Jewish tradition. And thousands of years ago, when we had a temple, the Kohanim, or the priestly tribe, they would bless the rest of the people. They put their hands out like this, both of their hands. I can't reach quite both of them, which has been adopted by Star Trek since. But so I'm going to ask you to put all your hands out if you can. If you can't, just try. It's kind of fun. And Adam, I want you to look around all these people who are sending their blessings to you. May God bless you and keep you. May God show their face unto you and show favor unto you. May God show themselves to you and protect you with peace always.